नमस्ते बिटिया, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। माई सेल्फ जीवियन डॉक्टर रितु शर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ गायनी ऑफ फैकल्टी ऑफ होम्योपैथिक साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। नाउ टुडे सेशन इज एंटीपार्टम फीटल सर्विलेंस, दैट इज लेट प्रेगनेंसी। ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर, फर्स्ट इज प्रिवेंशन of fetal death and second is avoidance of unnecessary intervention. Methods: clinical, biochemical, biophysical. Now clinical, the clinical assessment of fetal growth can be evaluated by the parameters mentioned earlier in chapter in the antenatal care. They may be used as screening test for further investigation. Biochemical tests are mainly done for assessment of pulmonary maturity. Biophysical principle: biophysical profile is a screening test for uteroplacental insufficiency. The fetal biophysical activities are initiated, modulated, and regulated through fetal nervous system. The fetal CNS is very much sensitive to diminished oxygenation. Now hypoxia, that result is metabolic acidosis. Then CNS depression, that result the changes in fetal biophysical activities. The following biophysical tests are used: first is fetal movement count, second is ultrasonography, third is cardiotocography, fourth is non-stress test, fifth is fetal biophysical profile BPP, 6th is Doppler ultrasound, 7th is vibroacoustic stimulation test, 8th is contraction stress test, 9th is amniotic fluid volume. The fetal movement count, any of the two methods can be applied. Cardiff count 10 formula. The patient counts fetal movement starting at 9 a.m. The counting comes to an end as soon as 10 movements are perceived. She is instructed to report the physician if the less than 10 movement occur during 12 hours on two successive days, or second is no movement is perceived even after 12 hours in a single day. Daily fetal movement count. Three counts each of 1 hour duration, morning, noon, and evening, are recommended. The total count multiplied by 4 gives daily 12 hours. Fetal movement count, if there is diminution of the number of kicks to less than 10 in 12 hours, it indicates fetal compromise. Mother perceives 88% of fetal movements detected by Doppler imaging. The count should be performed daily starting at 28 weeks of pregnancy. Loss of fetal movements is commonly followed by disappearance of FHR within next 24 hours. In either of the earlier methods, if the result is ominous, the candidate is subjected to NST. Maternal hypoglycemia is associated with increased fetal movements. Maternal perception of fetal movements may be reduced with fetal sleep, that is quiet, fetal anomalies, CNS, anterior placenta, hydramnios, obesity, drug necrotics, chronic smoking, and hypoxia. Non-stress test. The non-stress test, a continuous electronic monitoring of the fetal heart rate along with recording of fetal movement, cardiotocography is undertaken. There is observed association of FHR acceleration with fetal movements, which when present indicate a healthy fetus. It can reliably be used as a screening test. The acceleration of the fetus heart rate associated with fetal movement are presumably reflex mediated. It should be emphasized that the test is valuable to identify the fetal wellness rather than illness. Fetal cardiotachography. A normal taking after 32 weeks without show baseline heart rate, that is of 110 to 160 beat per minute, with an amplitude of baseline variability 5 to 25 BPM. There should be no declaration, or there may be earlier declaration of very short duration. Importantly, there should be two or more acceleration during a 20-minute period. Ultrasonography. IUGR can be diagnosed accurately with serial measurement of BPD, AC, HC, FL, and amniotic fluid volume. AC is the single measurement which best reflects fetal nutrition. The average increase of biparietal diameter beyond 34 weeks is 1.7 mm per week. When the RC by AC ratio is elevated more than 1.0 after 34 weeks, IUGR is suspected. Ultrasonography is the main diagnostic tool to assess fetal growth. Amniotic fluid volume. Amniotic fluid volume is primarily dependent upon the fetal urine output, pulmonary fluid production, and fetal swallowing. Decreasing amniotic fluid volume may be result of fetal hypoxia, placental insufficiency. A vertical pocket of amniotic fluid more than 2 cm is considered normal. Amniotic fluid index is the sum of vertical pockets from 4 quadrant of uterine cavity. Amniotic fluid volume less than 5 is associated with increase of perinatal mortality and morbidity. The features using UA Doppler flow abnormalities are a higher risk of intrauterine hypoxia. Risk of stillbirth is high when the Doppler flow in the ductus venous is abnormal. Use of ultrasonography for fetal biometry and Doppler study for umbilical artery flow velocimetry has reduced perinatal mortality and unnecessary early intervention significantly, and the contraction stress test is best to observe the response of the fetus at risk for uteroplacental insufficiency in relation to uterine contraction. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you.